WRC, WRC FM, Washington.
Okay, Eddie, come on in the studio. I think it's about 5 minutes after 7. Open the studio door.
All right, I guess it's about time for us to go on in here.
Here, set up the old... What?
Look at all this junk around here.
What is it?
It looks like a valise. Suitcase over here.
What is it? Who is it? Your valise? Don't open it.
Is it an overnight kit? Oh, I'm just tempted. I mean, every time I see a... It looks like... Well, let's just open it up, Jordan.
What is in there?
I don't know.
All my junk
in
there.
See, maybe one of the fellas is spending the night down here. Hey. One of the announcers got to sign on. Let's see, there's a crowbar.
There's a crowbar?
That doesn't make sense, does it? No. Here's a jimmy.
A jimmy?
Yeah, let's see. Here, looks like a couple of sticks of dynamite.
Oh, it must be a gag thing for somebody on
television. Nitroglycerin.
Oh, it must be a gag. Maybe that guy that used
box
to
box of dum-dum shells.
Mr. Gizzard used to be on television out of Chicago.
Look
maybe
at
he's
that.
Doing a guest shot here or something.
Looks like a do-it-yourself burglar kit or something here, doesn't it?
I don't know what he's doing in Studio 2.
I don't know either.
Put it, fold it up.
Yeah, I don't want to...
Yeah, I don't want the guy.
But play the theme, George.
George, play the theme.
And,
it's ridiculous. Nobody
will see whose it is.
Who left it in there? I'll call the
lost
operator.
Found,
yeah.
Though,
we had one.
We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
It's time for the Joy Boys show for Thursday night. This is Ed Walker here.
10, 15, 20, 25.
Willard Scott over there counting something. What are you doing?
Today's talent day.
Oh, you're getting paid, huh?
$20.
Wonderful.
Here's your five.
Huh? That doesn't make sense. Where's my cut?
You don't get nothing. Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. Bobby Shitton, our big nothing engineer, recording engineer.
I'd like to have a couple of bucks.
George Brunington.
The Hillbilly Record.
He is, of course, going down and whip up some old Hank Williams
records. We have an interesting show. That bothers me, that little valise full of those
Look,
tools.
Look, just forget it, will you? Just go ahead and re-up
the
show.
Who
in
the world would leave a thing like that in here? Huh.
What's that?
I don't know. It sounds like the... Open that door over there. See what's going on.
Hey, let me come in here before they get me.
What's the matter?
Oh, boy! Hey, hide me under the table, will you?
Perky, come out from under the table.
If the cops come in, you ain't seen me, you understand?
Perky, wait a minute,
huh?
Wait a minute.
That bell, I should have just got
all
three or four.
Let me go hit the wall and knock...
Oh.
Yeah.
Burned out the battery. Oh, boy.
Perky.
That's a close call.
Perky, will you calm down? Will you tell everybody what's wrong?
Well, you know, we pages don't make a whole lot of money. I mean, $10 a week. I was trying to supplement my income. I've been taking this course in burglary.
You mean that? Wait a minute.
And I'm pulling my first job tonight.
That kid over there.
On the vault upstairs.
That dynamite.
And it went off.
That glycerin. It all comes into
view.
That
yours, Perky?
Perky.
Well, yeah. They gave me my complete kit of equipment when I got my BB degree. That's Bachelor of Burglary.
And I noticed yesterday morning when I came in, I noticed the candy machine had been jimmied.
I did that one pretty slick, didn't I?
Oh, for heaven's sake. Perky.
I won't do it no more, fellas.
Look, here, you need money that much, let me give you... I've got in my wallet, I just got
give
paid
Give him the 20
today.
You
here,
got
I'll
there.
Give you a little...
Right.
I'll give
Gee,
you...
Gee, thanks. Coming from you,
Wait a minute.
Huh.
Perky.
So long, fellas.
Come here. Come back
Bye.
Here. That kid, that page. He took my money out of my wallet. He's a pickpocket.
No, not you, Paige. The other Paige.
Not that Paige.
Listen, the show's got to go
on. We'll
get the square later. I mean, we have an award today?
No. Yes, we do, Eddie. The
Good.
Power Mowers of America have just voted you and me the two gayest blades in radio.
That's pretty sharp, huh?
Coming up on our program, music. Glenn Gray, the Casaloma Orchestra, and that's the old Casaloma Stomp, boy.
I'm glad that record wasn't quacked.
Dodge dealers are sitting ducks for closeout sales on the 1960 Dodge Dart. They'll listen to any reasonable offer. They'll allow fantastic trade-ins, easy terms, low down payments. Your Metropolitan Dodge dealer has already broken sales records. He wants to break more. See him and save.
Got to come into our music library. You can break all the records. No, seems to me there must be a run on new Dodges. Did you ever see some? They're running right now. Did you ever see so many new Dodges?
Yeah.
One just ran out of the studio there. Dealers really must want to move them. And now's the time, right now, to go down to your Dodge dealer and have a look-see.
Look-see.
See. George. Excuse me,
Wait a minute. What's the matter with our production staff over there?
They're asleep. Here we go. John Hickman picked the wrong record. John.
August is here with all of its humidity. And here comes a girl who invented stupidity. Stepping out of her glass booth. Would you... Come, Miss...
What are you owing for? I'm the one who fell.
You fell over my leg, Miss Janitor. Oh. I think you broke it.
Ooh.
Set it in place gently, will you? Help her up, will you, Eddie?
Hey, here, Miss Janitor.
Put you one on the diet.
The folding chair is hooked on my ankle.
Here, take the chair off her ankle, will you? Help us get the chair up here.
Never in all my life. And that's a long time.
Here she is now. Washington's own weather girl, Miss Janitor with the Washington Paper Tours.
Fresh tomatoes, corn on the cob, bananas, oranges, peaches, apples, watermelon, cantaloupe.
Wait a minute here.
Hmm?
Tutti frutti.
What?
Would you tell me I don't get it.
Well, you see, I just opened up a roadside fruit stand, and I'm selling all of these fresh fruits out on MacArthur Boulevard in that general area. General MacArthur.
I see. At last, the worm has turned. We've got you where we want you.
Oh, you've tried some of my fruit, I see.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
The worm has turned.
I was going to say...
Stop by sometime.
This is illegal. You can't publicize, especially in the more recent months. We can't have any free plugs on the show.
I see.
Would you take your leader out of here?
Don't squeeze the banana. Squeeze the coconut, please.
Okay. Join Miss Janitor again.
Bye.
Sometime. Bye.
Ah.
That was Peggy Lee, and I guess what was that? Wasn't the one that was listed? That's what it was.
It wasn't the one that's listed,
wow,
baby. I like you to know. Wait a minute. I see we have our light. Our signal has been given to us from the engineer.
Yeah, we're going
to
go on anyway.
We're going to switch you now by remote recording to the beautiful Taft Room of the Roosevelt Grill in downtown New York, where we're going to speak, listen to some of the great music of one of our... I don't know what's going on. Let's switch it to... Come in, Charlie Nemo at the Tap Room of the Roosevelt Ho Grill. Hey!
Stand by. Good evening. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Charlie Nemo broadcasting from the Taft Room of the Hotel Grill in spacious New York City, just 3,000 miles from San Francisco, where we invite you now to join us for the very popular rhythms of Sammy Skin and his orchestra. Here we are. Willard Scott back in Washington. Are we coming in all right?
Yes, we got you loud and clear. Sounds great. Sammy Skin and the orchestra. Fine. We're all set for some rippling rhythm. So take it away, Charlie, and let's hear that music.
All right. Sammy Skin is a very remarkable young fella. He sings and plays drums at the same time. Is that right, Sammy?
That's absolutely right, Charlie. I'd like to give out a little number now. Me and the boys called the Sheik of Araby. Okay?
All right. Fine, Sammy. We're all ears.
I'm the Sheik of Araby. Your love belongs to me. At night when you're asleep, into your tent I'll creep. Oh, the stars that shine above, above, will light our way to love. Ooh, love, you'll rule this land with me. Oh, I'm the Sheik of Araby, of Araby. Oh, I'm the Sheik of Araby. Oh, the Sheik of Araby, your love belongs to me. Not him, but me. at night when you're asleep, not awake but asleep. Into your tent I'll creep. Oh, I will tell the stars to shine above. We'll light our way to love, love. You'll rule this land with me. They change keys. Oh, I'm the sheik of Arabi. Oh, boy, I'm getting a little tired here, fellas. If you don't mind. Oh. You'll excuse me for not singing a third chorus, Charlie, but you see, I handled the cocktail trade from 4 to 6, and I'm bushed.
That's perfectly all right, Sammy.
Oh.
Would you move him out of the studio, fellas? This is Charlie Nemo broadcasting from the beautiful tap room of the Hotel Grill. You've just heard the scintillating styles of Sammy Skin. And now back to our studios.
Thank you very much. That was wonderful. The rhythms there of Sammy Skin. We hope to switch you another hour right now. We're going back to the jail, so switch you now to the...
Wonderful! Wonderful!
Or match 'em dollar sale is here again. Tremendous varieties of food values for you to mix or match for a dollar in the 3 for $1 group. 30-ounce can of Townhouse fruit cocktail. And then there's the 9 1/4-ounce can of Sea Trader light meat chunk tuna. 8-ounce package of Bel Air fresh frozen asparagus spears. Values in the 8 for $1 selection. 16-ounce can of garden side tomatoes. 3 1/2-ounce can of Libby's potted meat food product. And the 10 for $1 combination, 3 1/2-ounce can of Maine sardines packed in oil, 3 1/2-ounce can of Maine sardines packed in mustard. There you are, just a few of the wonderful values that await you when you shop during the great Mix or Match 'em Dollar Sale at Safeway, where food is first.
Out of Northwest on MacArthur Boulevard come the thundering hoofbeats of Great Horse Platinum. With a cloud of dust and a hearty hi-ho slopper, the Sodbuster rides again. Nowhere in the pages of history can you find a greater champion of justice, a more fearless, hard-riding, straight-shooting, beer-drinking, pizza-eating son of the sod. It's the Sodbuster. A true gentleman of the old school. Men feared him, little children respected him. Women loved him. Ah, a true gentleman of the Old West.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Return with us now, those thrilling days of yesteryears. We find roaming about the Badlands, the Sodbuster.
Sodbuster, we had to get a new announcer there. The other one, I'm just the engineer, actually, on the desk up here. Where were we? I've lost my place. Did he say the bit about the nowhere in the pages
yes,
of history?
He did.
Can we find a greater champion?
It's time to set the scene for the story.
Out of Northwest on MacArthur Boulevard.
Yeah, he's done all of that. No, we're down here.
I don't even know the format sheet for this particular show. Is the Chester?
Yeah, the Sodbuster and his sidekick, Chester Dinner.
His sidekick, Chester
Dinner. Come here, Chester.
Oh, yes, Master Dealer, you got me right in the side. I don't know at all where we are. You better take it from here.
The sun has just settled down over the sleepy little town of Rockville.
I've got it. I've got
and
it.
And most of the town...
I just found that the sun had just settled down in the sleepy town of Rockville. As our story opens, the Sodbuster speaks.
I hope that Chester doesn't come in here now while I'm busy working here. I can't get any work done with Chester. Let's see if I'll try this one here. Back in the saddle again. Out where a friend is a friend. Where the longhorn cattle feed. That's not too good. Let's try this one here. Happy trails to you. Happy trails to you. Well, that's not too good either. Let's see. I don't know just which one I am going to do here. Let me see. Maybe... Uh-oh, here comes Chester. I guess I better go back to back in the saddle.
Well,
again.
Mr. Dillard, or is he, Marshal? It's been so hot outside.
Hey, Chester, I'm trying to do something here.
I noticed a hound dog was baying outside
Chester.
The
Chester! What? It was me singing. That wasn't no hound dog baying at the moon.
What on earth are you doing with all these songs in here, Marshal?
Well, Chester, I've decided that all them big cowboys have a theme, you know, like Roy Rogers and Gene Autry and all those fellas, so I've decided I'm going
to
get me a theme song, too.
Say Finks, didn't you, Mr.
Yes,
Miller?
Well, I did.
Your contemporaries, Marshal.
What?
Contemporary.
Where'd you learn a word like that, Chester? I told you not to hang around that Short Branch Saloon, didn't I?
Oh, well, I watch Open End every Sunday night.
What? What would you suggest for a theme, Chester?
I heard one not too long ago, Marshal.
What's that?
When it's round
we have time
in Texas, and your bloomers are on the sage.
No, Chester, the bloomers on the sage. Now, get out of here and let me do my work, will you? That's Tom Mix's theme song.
I'm sorry.
Goodness
I was trying to help you out there.
Maybe I should have been here when they had silent movies.
I think I can finish this. No. The Sodbusters written by Moby Dick, produced by NBC News over the weekend. The entire production is directed by Horace Opera, and it's supervised for NBC Radio by Billy the Kid. This has been a Saddle Sore production. They got me right in my after card.
What was Gabby Hayes' theme song,
anyway? Me and Roy.
We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
That's the Joy Boys for tonight. This is Ed Walker.
Weller Scott thanking George Brewington. Arthur Page.
Yeah.
Bobby Shepard.
John Hickman. John, thank you very much.
Wonderful old show. Hope you're
doing one more commercial for the show here.
Too late, Perky. The show's all over. We'll see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Listen.
We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
Mac. Rife gets a sharpener tonight on the NBC Radio Network.
Things can't go on this way.
No, just the way they did a minute ago, they shouldn't. WRC, WRC-FM, Washington.
Boy, you know, it really is a pleasure for once in the middle of the week to finally get settled in the studio here and not have to rush. What on... Eddie, did you see the size of that fly that went by?
In the first place, we're downstairs. There are no windows here. What I want to know is, how did he get in here?
Obviously, it must be the air conditioner or something. He probably can't... Look at the size of that fly.
Boy, get him out of here.
Yeah, Arthur, see if he can't...
Don't have a fly swatter.
No fly swatter? Look, Bobby. Bobby? Is there a fly swatter or an old book or something over there? Nothing? Oh, come on. No way. Art Hallam is over there, resting. Art, can't you find anything to get that...
Sorry, nothing here.
Nothing to get the... That's the biggest
he's
fly.
He's diving around. Looks like he's doing, you know, trick flight or something there.
Ridiculous. Are they in the middle? Look at him. Looks like a P-38 as he goes down there. I saw old war movies at the... Well, anyway, let's try to ignore him. Coming up on our program, a very exciting show this evening. We think you'll enjoy it very much. It's going to be a very big, you know, show. We have some interview with a man who is... invented a back scratcher, as a matter of fact. We are also going to do a special feature called the... That fly is out of its mind. That really bothers me a little bit, you know?
Let's see if I can get in here.
Okay, just be... Oh, you'll never reach him. He's up on the ceiling. Yeah. Let me just re-up the program before we get our nerves all frayed. You think one evening we come down here and get our show done on time, that we could at least get something, but not on a... The Sodbuster will also ride along out of the northwest here, too, so keep your dial set to this. Now, what was that?
The fly just flew right through the control room window.
Let me pick him up over here. Hey, little fella. Fly? Oh, you know, I really
biggest fly I've ever seen.
Look, put the theme on, and I'll call the Red Cross. Maybe we can do something with him here. Come here, fella. Give him some artificial rest. He ran into the control room, didn't he?
The Joy Boys of Radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of Radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
I have the distinct feeling that somebody was hissing our performance when that theme went on. Did you notice
Bobby,
that?
Bobby, what are you going... A hiss and a what?
He said that the preamp in the turntable had a hiss in it.
Couldn't you make it hiss again?
Even the equipment doesn't like your show. Let's be realistic here.
Well, we do our best. At least we do our... We try.
We try, yes,
at least
we
try. In this modern age when nobody cares, we try.
This is Ed Walker trying all his might here on this Thursday evening.
Well, it's got over here, and we are going to have a very exciting
program. You said
program.
That already.
Oh,
I mentioned.
Did
Art
I read
Page here.
Oh, thank you, Art. Sign in. Come in, mystery guest, and sign in, please.
Yeah. Get that guy out of here. Now then,
we got him fixed up again.
We have an award here. A little bit early, a little unseasonal.
Pretty
but,
tough to put a crutch on a fly, you know.
Better than putting a cast on him. He'd, you know, he'd be top heavy. We have an award here, a little unseasonal, but
put a cast on the fly, Bobby.
The jack-o'-lantern manufacturers of America have just voted us the two biggest spooks in radio. I don't know.
That's a pretty sick bit. I mean, really.
I do believe that's the Jonah Jones group there, and that particular number is called So Blue. That's what it is. Would you like to do the honors on this next one?
You gonna let me read the commercial?
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
It's a challenge. See if you can get it all in the allotted time.
Should we take some bets on this?
No, that's all right. I have faith in you. All right. Give him the downbeat, Professor.
More cool ideas from Safeway for those hot August days. Bel-Air Fresh Frozen Lemonade and Bel-Air Fresh Frozen Pink Lemonade. Made from selected fresh quality lemons, Bel-Air Fresh Frozen Lemonade makes the ideal cooling, refreshing hot weather drink, plus the extra of real nutritional value for your family. Relax and refresh with Bel-Air Fresh Frozen Lemonade and Bel-Air Fresh Frozen Pink Lemonade. Bel-Air Fresh Frozen Lemonade is featured this week at Safeway, the 6-ounce can, 6 for 69 cents, and the 12-ounce can, 3 for 65 cents. And Bel-Air Fresh Frozen Pink Lemonade, the 6-ounce can, 6 for 69 cents at Safeway, where food is always first.
You did it!
I'm finished it. At your friendly Safeway store.
Ah, you did it wonderful.
Your friendly Safeway store.
Let's sing it together.
Your friendly Safeway store.
And now the Joy Boys proudly presents The Unmentionables. Once again, we present The Unmentionables from actual case histories of the violence in Chicago during the 20s. This is a Whoop-Dee-Doo production starring Robert Flack as Elliot Mess, and here is your narrator, Walter Walter.
Good evening, this is North and South America and all the ships at sea. The year was 1921, July 21st. A small rib joint on Chicago's south side. For 6 months, a jukebox war had been raging between the two most hated gangs in Chicago, the Big Squares from the north side and the Swingin' Daddies from the south side. It was a war for the control of the jukebox industry, one of the biggest nickels and dimes rackets of the early 20s. Lefty Louie was a Guy Lombardo fan, and Downbeat Charlie wanted the jukes to carry Dixieland records. Everywhere in Chicago, on both sides, the north and the south, the scene was the same. Wherever there was music playing from the Dixieland nature, there was always the gang coming in, always from the north side. There he was, always waiting. Lefty Louie, a Guy Lombardo fan who couldn't leave things well enough alone.
Okay, fellas, you know what to do with that jukebox playing the Dixieland music. Let's have it.
This was the scene all over the side. It couldn't be any different. Every single place that Lefty Louie went, with his North Siders on the South Side, they would destroy the Dixieland music and wreck the jukebox machines. But on the other side of the world, it was no different. For everywhere that they went, these were the South Siders, and they roamed the North Side in search of one thing, jukeboxes playing Guy Lombardo records.
Fellas, fellas, how can you possibly stand to shatter your nerves with this square music? Well, you know what to do, don't you, Herman?
Okay! Take that, you dirty jukebox machine! And that, and that!
And so, it went on. From July 21st, 1921, till October 13th, 1928. On the South Side, jukeboxes were blown to bits. On the North Side, jukeboxes were blown to bits. After having destroyed 7,856 jukeboxes, the South Siders and the North Siders finally decided something had to be done. A meeting was called for, and it looked like there was going to be a big league compromise. And so a special secret meeting was set up by federal agent Elliot Mess in the basement of the old record distributor's home. It was November 16th, 1928. The two principal suspects, Lefty Louie, the Guy Lombardo fan from the North Side, and of course, our old pal, the guy that we talked about many times before, he was there too, our friend from the South Side. Everywhere they went, there was music, and there was laughter, and the meeting was decided upon, and the following took place.
Hello, Downbeat Charlie. Well, hello, Louie. Elliot Mess, thank you for setting up this secret meeting here.
I suppose you two boys know why we're here.
Well, yeah, I suppose that the unmentionables are getting tired of us shooting up all the jukeboxes in Chicago.
It seems a little ridiculous that 7,856 jukeboxes have been destroyed.
Well, just a second, Elliot. I mean, after all, just because we have different tastes in
Wait.
Music...
There is no need for this. There is no need to destroy these jukeboxes.
Well, okay.
You boys can get together and decide something
What's
for yourself.
What's your plan, Mess? I'm a busy man. I got deals cooking.
Yeah, me too, Elliot. If you got something to tell us, tell us.
There's a new kid somewhere up in the Dakotas. I heard him play last Saturday night as I was up there at a special party that we were on with the Federal Agents Division.
The Dakotas?
He's a kid that's just coming up in the world, but I think if you guys work with him and with him again, that you can find that he'll be very valuable to you.
Wait a minute. They play polka music up in the Dakotas.
Things are changing in the Dakotas.
You got this guy here?
Just a minute. Larry, would you come on in here, please?
One of our most requested songs for dancing is the fine old favored Whispering. It certainly deserves a place in this collection of great songs.
Kind of like this guy.
Yeah, me too, Charlie. I think maybe he has got possibilities. Elliot, you're a real pal. Elliot?
How do you like that? Elliot went to sleep.
And so, on that evening of November 16th, 1928, in the old record distributor's home, a compromise was reached. Another job well done by the unmentionables and federal agent Elliot Mess.
You have been listening
Good
to
night.
The Unmentionables.
Excuse me.
You have been listening to The Unmentionables, a Whoop-Dee-Doo production, starring Robert Flack as Elliot Mess and narrated by Walter Walter.
Good night.
That's Miss Peggy Lee in the
yes,
song
sir,
is Oh
right
Johnny,
you
and you're listening to the Joy Boys show with yours truly, Ed Walker and Willard Scott. Well, this Thursday. Willard, is our guest ready now?
Yes, Edward, he certainly is, and we are very delighted to have in our
and
studio...
I'll sit right down here.
a gentleman you. Who's done something that's quite exciting and quite interesting and something that I believe will affect all of us. Would you sit down here, please, sir?
I'm sitting already, yes,
You've
I am.
You've met Mr. Walker?
I've met Hello, Mr. Walker.
Our engineers.
Yes, sir.
There's Bob Shenton, Arthur Hallam, Art Page over there, Willard Scott here. Mr. Timothy Tickle is in our...
That's correct.
Mr. Tickle, welcome to our program.
Yes, yes.
It's our pleasure to interview you. You have done something that's quite unique and quite revolutionary, have you not?
I think so, yes. I don't think you could quite classify this as a necessary item in every home yet. It might be sort of a luxury for the time being, but the time is coming in our modern society where this will be a must.
What have you invented? Excuse me.
I have invented an automatic back scratcher.
Automatic back scratcher.
Right. How many times have you come home and found out that you're trying to get comfortable and you just have a little itch in your back and you start scraping your back on the doorway or on the back of a chair and you try to get somebody to scratch it for you?
Reach way back yourself and practically break your elbow trying to get to it, or even the old-fashioned back scratcher doesn't do too much good because you can't quite get to it sometimes and there's so much effort in when you do, right?
That is absolutely correct. So I have perfected the Timothy Tickle automatic back scratcher.
This is a fantastic machine. Let me describe it. It's about 3 feet deep and about 2.5 feet wide. Would you tell us, what is this big unit on top here? It looks like some sort of a box of a gear.
That, my friend, is a radar unit.
A radar unit?
That's right. You'll notice there is a small camera built in that box on the top there.
I see that like one of those dimmers, automatic dimmers in an automobile. Yeah.
Now, you put these electrodes on you. Just pass them right on the wrist. I'll put them on mine here. I'll demonstrate it for you.
Electrodes? You mean like they're using the space satellite monkeys?
Right. That's correct. Now, these electrodes register on the screen back there, showing just exactly what part of your back is beginning to itch.
What registers?
Well, the impulses are registered on the screen, and then the camera picks it up.
Impulses of the itch register on the
screen?
That
is correct.
Fantastic.
Then we have an automatic back scratcher, which is regulated by a little motor.
What does the radar unit do?
The radar unit transmits the picture of where your back is itching to the automatic back scratcher.
And it zeroes in on
And it comes right in on the beam, as they say.
What is this big rubber thing hanging down from the...
Well, that is the scratcher. This is an old rubber glove with the pebbles in the fingers.
And it's sort of flexible, too. It'll move around.
Right.
Look at that, Eddie. It's like feelers there. That's amazing.
Now, would you like to see it in operation, gentlemen? Well,
you have the electrode strapped to your arms.
My back is beginning to itch right now, and I'll just turn on the...
Let me put a little salt on your back so it'll itch good.
All right.
I'll put the salt right here.
Turn on the machine here now.
All right.
Now, the motor is... Ooh, that feels good. There you see?
Look at
the radar is
zooming into position.
The radar is coming in on the beam.
The arm is moving. Let me describe. The arm is now moving from the box. It's coming about a half, 3-4 feet across the room. And now it has reached Mr. Tickle's back. And it's missed your back. Except Mr. Tickle.
I'm ticklish.
Yeah. The radar unit apparently is off. I think you better get an adjustment. Art, what are you guys coming here?
Can you stop this machine?
The long arm with the rubber glove stuffed with rocks is tickling Mr. Tickle in the rib. And I think that you've blown a tube. Mr. Tickle, you have blown a tube. Could you call maintenance?
Would you scratch my back for me?
Yeah, come here. Hold still. I realize.
It's much better.
Yeah, it's hold still.
These machines
are
now, our next feature.
From out of Northwest and Mikasa Boulevard come the thundering hoofbeats, the great horse Platinum. With a cloud of dust and a hearty high-ho slobber, the Sodbuster rides again. Nowhere in the pages of history can you find a greater champion of justice, a more fearless, hard-riding, straight-shooting, beer-drinking, pizza-eating son of the sod. It's the Sodbuster! A true gentleman of the old school. Men feared him, little children respected him, women loved him. A true gentleman of the old West. Return with us now to those thrilling days of any old year as we find roaming about the wild badlands of the old West, U.S. Marshal Matt Dillard, the Sodbuster. The Sodbuster, U.S. Marshal Matt Dillard, that is sidekick Chester Troy.
Hello, Chester.
Yes, Mr. Dillard. Marshal, you kicked me right in the side. I don't know.
In and around the territory of the Old West, there was only one way to handle the spoilers and lawless men, and that was the smell of pipe smoke and the Sodbuster. Our scene is early afternoon. Our story opens up. The Marshal, Matt Dillard, and Chester Drawers, for the past 3 hours, had been working in the marshal's office counting foodstuffs that the prisoners ate while they were in jail. Unfortunately, the marshal had been called out on business. There'd been some cattle rustling. The marshal has just returned, and he and Kitty are walking back towards
yes,
the marshal's
office. I'm glad you caught those rustlers.
Yeah, me too, Kitty. They were tough hombres. Well, Chester?
Chester's
still taking inventory here.
Oh, that's fine. Well, I'll be running on over to the short branch, Matt.
Bye, Kitty.
Bye.
Howdy, Marshal.
Well, Chester, I caught the cattle rustlers. Now, I guess we're ready to continue taking inventory here.
Good, Marshal. Just good.
All right, where's that list we were using here? Right here?
Here it is, Marshal, right
Something
here.
Wrong, Chester?
Oh, no. Just sitting here.
All right, you want to climb up on the ladder there, and I'll tell you what we're supposed to have here.
Let me get up here on the...
Easy does it. Easy does it.
All right, Marshal.
All right, now, let's see here. According to the list, we should have 15 pounds of coffee.
Here you go. 15 pounds of coffee, check.
All right, 20 pounds of sugar.
Here's a 20-pound sack of sugar, Marshal.
All right, 10 jars of grape jelly.
Here's one. 10 jars of grape jelly.
And 5 pounds of potatoes.
5 pounds...
And 50 packages of peanut butter crackers.
4 packages of peanut butter crackers.
Chester, I said we had 50 packages of peanut butter crackers.
Come on down here.
How many did you say we had?
Marshal, there's only 4 packages up there. Sure, there must be something wrong with your list.
I don't think so, Chester. What's the matter with you? Chester.
Marshal. I don't know, Marshal. I just...
Come here. Come here. Have you been drinking? Come here. Let me smell your breath. Chester drawers.
Well, I was so hungry and you were gone so dead blame long, I just couldn't stand
you
it.
You ate 46 packages of peanut butter crackers.
Four more. Laugh, Marshal.
The Sodbuster is written by Moby Dick, produced by the NBC Newsroom on the weekends, directed by Horace Opera. The entire production is supervised for NBC Radio by Billy the Kid. This has been a Saddle Sore production.
We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
There you have the Joy Boys show for Thursday night. Till tomorrow, then, this is Ed Walker.
Willard Scott thanking Bobby Shetton, Arthur Hallam.
Thank you.
And Arthur Page.
Yeah.
John Hickman picked the music.
John, you did a great job, kid. You've been eating those peanut butter crackers, too, huh?
Let me smell your breath, John.
This is Charlie Staffer, your announcer, reminding you that this program has been selected to be heard by our armed forces overseas.
We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
The Joy Boys program is heard by more people every day than any other program in the nation's capital over NBC.
WRC,
WRC-FM, NBC in Washington. At the sound of the tone, Eastern Daylight Saving Time, 7:30.
From the laboratory to the highway. The 1960 Ambler with removable main spring.
Plus, power push button seats that raise the driver up to the roof. Room for 7 Watusi Warriors to fit lengthwise. The widest wagon on the road. And now, for the first time on any station wagon, topo pull. No doors. The roof simply comes off and the passengers are catapulted in their seats by an old Roman system. And the biggest news of all, the 1960 Ambler is all noise-free from rattles and distracting noises. It's solid uni-uni construction. No assembly line. The Ambler is carved out of a solid piece of steel, hollowed out, tires put on her, and away she goes. Remember, don't be a gambler, get an Ambler. See your Ambler dealer today.
Well, now, Arthur, really.
That was scheduled.
Pretty corny commercial. I don't...
Almost as big a nothing as the following show.
7 Watusi Warriors. Who wrote the copy for the commercial?
I did.
Well, that's what I figured. Play the theme and just... Let's go.
the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
All right, and a good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen. Hopscotching the world for headlines. Last time I'll try to imitate a newsman. Good evening, it's Tuesday, and time for the Joy Boys once again. Walker and Scott without the Walker. Scott is here, Walker is on vacation, and our staff of stellar engineering pizzos are here. We have behind the glass Bobby Shenton, who's always with us. Windy old son of a gun. And then, of course, Arthur Page, who's over there behind the controls.
Nothing always big, nothing.
And, of course, John Hickman, who picks the music, is here. Thank you, John. And K.B. Butch Williams.
Yes, it is.
I don't understand why we don't seem to ever have any cooperation on this show at all, period. We wish to thank a few of the people who made tonight's program possible. The lieutenant over at Precinct Number 8, who let our engineering staff out for the weekend. The program director of Channel 9, just to mention a few of the people who are responsible for this evening's program. Coming up on our show tonight, Aunt Harriet, the friendly radio storyteller, will tell another one of her friendly radio stories. Pretty miserable copy. The Sodbuster will ride out of the recording studio, jamming at the bit here on the wrong night. It'll be very exciting. Randolph W. Goon will recite some poems. And gentlemen, I am proud to say that we do have an award. We have been awarded a very exciting Medal of Honor, the Joy Boys program. The hay fever sufferers of Washington have just voted the Joy Boys the biggest sneeze in radio. Watch it, fella. Hello. Fella, would you?
Fella.
No, madam, there's absolutely nothing wrong with your set. No, it's the record. Please, madam, yes, go back to your dinner. Croquettes, I love chicken croquettes. No, I can't, I'm on the air now. No. Yeah, keep in the icebox, I'll see you later. Okay, bye. One of our listeners calling, and they can't believe it. I can't either, boys. That was pretty,
Nothing, all the way. Big nothing.
Yeah, that's one of the big nothings of our program. That was Charlie Barnett in the orchestra, and that's called The Wrong Idea.
It's pretty bad.
Pretty bad record. Who asked you? Go back to rechanging the tire on your sports car. Just forget it. We have a public service announcement to make, keeping up with the people in town who are hay fever sufferers. We're going to do all we can to give you the comfort that you demand. We have just received from our bureau upstairs, the pollen count is now 72.6. And now, boys and girls, chocolate-covered cuckoos bring you the exciting Aunt Harriet, your friendly radio storyteller, with today's children's story for all you little kiddies out there. Remember, cuckoo, the greatest name in chocolate. Now, here she is, friendly Aunt Cuckoo.
Harriet, thank you, Mr. Announcer, and a good afternoon to all my little boys and girls who are my friends listening in. This afternoon, we have a very exciting story.
Hands off me, you freak.
This afternoon, we're going... Shh, Junior, we're on the air, son.
What's the matter with these?
You're late.
Parole office or something.
You're supposed to be...
The rules of the game.
You're supposed to be here 10 minutes before we go on the air. Where were you, Junior?
Some little creep paid me an offense after school. I let him have one right in the chops.
Oh, I see. I notice you have a bloody nose there.
Give me some bubblegum and tell your obnoxious, nauseating story.
Junior, when the adults are talking, we're quiet, aren't we?
Get 40 bucks a week.
Junior!
You blab at the chops here.
This afternoon, Shh, Junior, would you stop chewing so loudly, please?
Boy, dear? Does this stuff taste foul.
Please, that's one of our alternate sponsors, Junior. Don't
please,
talk about
it. Tastes like a five-day-old buffalo in your mouth.
Don't talk about hoo-ha bubblegum.
Tastes like a sandhog just took his foot out of my...
This afternoon, boys and girls...
What are we having today? Goldilocks and the Three Finks?
No, Junior, we're telling the story of Jack and the Beanstalk.
Oh, brother.
Once upon a time, there was a little boy named Jack, and he and his mother were very poor and lived on the outskirts of town in a humble little house.
Kenwood.
Yes. No! And one day, Jack's mother said, Jack, things are so bad that we're going to have to sell our favorite cow.
Now, wait a minute, what's a modern family? What do they call Thompsons? A friendly milkman or something?
Junior, would
got
you be quiet?
A cow in a neighborhood?
Now then, Jack took
the
old cow into
to
town, and on his way to town, he met a man who offered Jack a handful of beans.
What a con man. Now the story's getting good.
So Jack took the handful of beans from this nice man who took the cow from Jack. Jack got home, his mother was so angry because Jack hadn't gotten any money for his cow.
So his mother didn't take any bull from Jack and she put him to bed, right?
Exactly, without his supper. I'm telling the story.
Why didn't he call Eddie Leonard's and get one sent out, a sandwich or something?
Because it was before they had Eddie Leonard's, Junior.
Why don't you get with it?
Junior, why don't you get with it? I'm trying to be nice and tell you a story, but you won't be quiet when the adults are talking. Now, you know what Aunt Harriet will have to do to you if you don't be quiet.
Threats, threats, threats.
Junior, what are you doing?
Hey, Aunt Harriet.
And so, boys and girls, join us again next week when once more, Cuckoo, the greatest name in chocolate, will again bring you your friendly radio storyteller, Aunt Harriet.
Next week, boys and girls, we're going to tell the story of Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Well, wonderful, Aunt Harriet. We'll all be listening. Now, boys and girls, goodbye. This was recorded bit 1, take 3, channel 4, Segway switch 2, X. Safeway's featuring this week the ice cream you serve with pride, Lucerne Party Pride. All flavors in the half gallon, only 79 cents. Here is mellow richness in ice cream that means you have just served the finest for your money. Lucerne Party Pride ice cream from Safeway. Try making different dishes with Lucerne Party Pride ice cream, like butterscotch swirl or cake topping made with whipped ice cream and garnished with fresh fruit. Pick up your favorite flavor of Lucerne Party Pride ice cream. All flavors in the half-gallon container, only 79 cents this week at Safeway, where food is first, at your friendly neighborhood Safeway store. Shop Safeway, where food always is first. Music here by Frank Sinatra, Nelson Riddle's orchestra, and Let's Get Away From It All. That's his new Capitol recording. This is the Joy Boys program for this day, Tuesday, and this is still the 20-something another of August, 1963rd. Thank you. And coming up on our program, a very exciting feature. I think you'll all enjoy the Sodbuster. First of all, as a public service announcement, we would like to remind you hay fever sufferers, the pollen count is now 78.1.5. From out of Northwest on MacArthur Boulevard come the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse Platinum. With a cloud of dust and a hearty high-ho slobber, the Sodbuster rides again. Nowhere in the pages of history can you find a greater champion of justice, a more fearless, hard-riding, straight-shooting, beer-drinking, beets-eating son of the sod. It's the Sod Buster. A true gentleman of the old school. Men feared him, little children respected him, women loved him. Ah, yes, a true gentleman of the West. Return with us now to the thrilling days of any old years we find roaming about the vile badlands of the Old West, the Sod Buster. The Sod Buster, U.S. Marshal Matt Dillard, and his sidekick, Chester Drawer.
Come here, Chester.
Yes, mister. Oh, Marshal, you kicked me right in the side.
In and around the territory of Hyattsville, on beyond Tacoma Park, out past Four Corners rode the Sodbuster, U.S. Marshal Matt Dillard, and his sidekick, Chester Drawers. The sun had been down for about 3 hours now in the sleepy town of Rockville, as U.S. Marshal Matt Dillard searches diligently for his sidekick, Chester Drawers, who's been missing all afternoon. It's late evening.
I've been searching diligently for my sidekick, Chester Drawer, since this afternoon, and now it's late evening. Hope nothing's happened to the boy. There were some cattle rustlers roaming around here yesterday. Don't know where he could be. It's getting late. I guess I'll walk up here to the short branch and see if Miss Kitty has seen Chester. He may have stopped off there for a game of cards. Miss Kitty?
Howdy, Marshal.
Howdy, Sam.
Yes, we want Matt.
Miss Kitty, has Chester been in here in the last couple hours?
No, I haven't seen him, Marshal.
Okay, thank you, Miss Kitty. Oh, dear, he's not here. Well, let's see, he's not in the livery stable. I looked there. He's not at the depot watching the trains come in. He's not at the telegraph office. Guess I'll have to go by the office and just sit and wait a little longer.
Where the buffaloes roam.
What's that noise?
Where the deer
sounds like
and
Chester.
The antelope play.
Behind the office. Let me go back here and see what's going on. Chester!
Hold on, horsey.
Chester!
Hold on, horsey.
Chester, I've been looking for you since this afternoon. Where you been, boy?
Well, sir, howdy, Marshal.
Thought something terrible had happened to you.
Mighty powerful good to see you, Marshal.
Chester, I was afraid those cattle rustlers got you, boy. Where you been?
No, sir, ain't nothing like that, Marshal. I've been busy all day. Hold on now, horsey.
What are you doing with that horse, Chester?
Well, Marshal, you know tonight's the last night you can have district license plates on your horse.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
New 1960 license plates go into effect tomorrow, and I was late. I got my license, and I'm putting them on the horse now.
Chester, you're not supposed to put... Look what
just
you
a
got.
Minute, Marshal. I'll... There.
You don't expect that horse to walk with those plates on him, do you?
Well, you watch this. Oh, steady, fella. Oh, here we go. I'm back in.
What's that noise, Chester?
That's a license plate on his hoof, Marshal. Come on, boy, let's go.
You know what? I forgot to get my license plates. I better run down there and get them now before it's too late, Chester.
The Sodbuster is written by Moby Dick, produced for NBC Radio by the NBC Newsroom on the weekends, directed by Dave Reckway, and this is... Directed by Horace Opera. The entire production is supervised for NBC Radio by Billy the Kid. This has been a Saddle Sore production. End bit, six, take, cut. Segway, enter, beep, cue. Well, very exciting production there. The Sodbuster riding out of the old Northwest on MacArthur Boulevard. As a public service announcement, ladies and gentlemen, we are asked now at this time to present for hay fever sufferers the latest pollen count. The pollen count as of this hour, 94.7.
Spring is here, the grass has riz. I wonder where the flowers is. Poetry from the pen of one of America's finest poets. Brought to you now as we come to the end of another workaday. People wending their way homes to relax and enjoy the poetry of Randolph W. Goon on Goon River Anthology. We're awaiting the arrival of Mr. Goon now, and he will soon be with us. Oh.
in the studio.
Round two of the cavalcade of sports.
Mr. Goon. Mr. Goon is in the studio. Mr. Goon.
Darn this messy studio.
I don't think you were aware of the fact that we are on the air.
Well, I certainly wasn't.
And millions of Americans are awaiting your poetic word.
Not according to the ratings, buddy.
And now,
here's watching television.
Mr. Goon's first poem for this evening, entitled The Birds of Spring.
Tra-la.
Tra-la.
Thank you, and good evening, poor lovers. The Birds of Spring. The birds of spring, how do they sing? Sound a little like Bing, those birds of spring. In the treetops, on the phone lines, some even sound like lily pines.
Oh, no.
In the morning when I wake, they're singing. Sounds like an earthquake. In the evening when I'm retiring, they keep on singing and I'm not lying. If they don't stop that singing, my head will be ringing from that singing, singing, singing. I'm losing my mind. They're driving me crazy. I flip my lid. Crazy birds are making me go mad. If those birds don't stop their singing, I'm going to call the police.
Mr. Goon, I think you got carried away.
And then the sound of birds singing.
I gathered that.
By the bugs.
I see. And now,
Oh.
Your next poem for this evening, in a more quiet vein, we hear... What is it titled?
The Daffodil.
The Daffodil. Yes, the Daffodil.
Daffodil. Last fall, when it was cold and cloudy, I left my fireside and said howdy to old Mother Earth. The ground was cold and solid, but with my automatic electric shovel, I disembodied bits of soil from its rocky bed. With patience and felicitude, my daffodil bulbs I did pursued to get into the ground before the snow fooled. All winter long I've waited, checked the yard and cultivated, until at last their little leaves I did just last week spy. Warmth and sunshine made them healthy, and the higher they did grow, until just yesterday their yellow from the bulbs I did plant they did sow, show.
I don't either. We'll have a translation.
But only this morning before I came to work, some mean old squirrel had chewed off the top and ate it. That mean old jerk.
Thank you,
Mr.
Goon.
Yes.
And now in closing, here's Mr. Goon's thought for today.
Life is not a bowl of cherries. Persimmons, perhaps, but never cherries.
I see. You've just heard...
Didn't get it. I thought the writer
Goon
said it
River Anthology with our poet, Mr. Randall W. Goon. If you wish... Yes, if you wish copies of today's poem, please enclose cash, check, or money order to the tune of $5,000 to Randolph W. Goon.
That's the spirit. Now you're getting with it.
He has a mortgage to pay off and
income tax.
You understand. So until next week, we say good night.
Whose Jeep is parked out front of the studio?
Tonight's program was on tape. Adhesive, not video.
We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
Well, good people, that just about does it for this exciting Tuesday edition of the Joy Boys. Thank you very much for listening. Thanks to K.B. Williams.
I'm glad to be.
And thanks to good old Bobby Shenton. And Arthur Page.
Nothing.
John Hickman picked the music. We'll all see you again tomorrow, same time, same station. Ed Walker's on vacation. This show is heard by our armed forces in Rockville.
We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
Tonight, Priscilla Alden sings It's So Nice to Have a Man Around the House on the NBC Radio Network.
NBC in Washington, WRC, WRC FM.